Lucy Show, starring Lucille Ball, co-starring Vivian Vance.
It's dark and overcast. What's so beautiful about it?
It's Friday.
So
after Friday comes Saturday and Sunday. A whole weekend away from the schoolroom grind.
Yeah, well, just remember, after Sunday, there's always Monday.
Please, not while I'm eating.
Oh, Jerry.
Good morning, Mom.
Good morning, Viv. Good morning. Well, you certainly got out of the wrong side of the bed.
With that bed of mine, there's no other side to get out on.
What do you mean by that?
Every muscle in my body aches. Lucy, you're just going to have to do something about that lumpy mattress of mine.
Oh, Viv, I'll get you something to eat. What would you like?
Orange juice, coffee, and a massage.
Aren't you coming, Chris? Yeah. Cynthia's mother's taking us.
Oh, Sharon, come here a minute now. Remember, now I'm going to pick you up at school this afternoon so we can get an early start to Uncle Ned.
Oh, that's right. I forgot we were going away for the weekend.
Here we are, honey. Have a nice day.
Bye, Deb.
Bye.
Bye, Mrs.
Bye, Mom.
Bye-bye. Oh, my aching back. One good thing about going to Uncle Ned's, I'll get a good night's sleep.
Viv, if you're hinting around for a new mattress, you can just forget it. Your lease says room and board, and that's it.
Yeah, but I didn't know the board was going to be in my room, and I didn't...
Do you know how much a new mattress would cost? I can't afford it. I'm not made of money, you know.
You know, Lucy, if you had a mustache and a deeper voice, I'd swear I was having breakfast with my ex-husband.
Oh, Viv.
You know, I hate to say this, but do you know what you're turning into? A penny-pinching landlord.
I am not.
Yes, you are. The next thing I know, you'll be turning off the heat in my room and making me put a quarter in every time I want to watch television.
Oh, Viv, honestly.
Well, I gotta go get dressed. I'm gonna get a permanent. Oh, at least I'll get some sleep under the dryer.
Mom, why don't you buy Aunt Viv a new mattress?
Because there's nothing wrong with the one that she has. If it was good enough for me, it's good enough for her.
When did you sleep on that mattress?
When I was your age.
Wow, wait!
Chris, I said I slept on it, not George Washington.
But Aunt Viv does pay rent. Isn't she entitled to one?
Yeah, I suppose she is. By George, she's right. I am turning into a penny-pinching landlord.
Oh, Mom.
Yes, I am. What's the matter with me, anyway? Well, I'll make it up to her. When she comes home Sunday night, I'll have a big surprise for her. I'll fix over her whole room. I'll wash the curtains and wax the floors, and I'll get her the best mattress a credit can buy. I'm up here, kids, in Aunt Viv's room.
Hi.
Hi, don't tramp on the floor. I just waxed it.
Whee!
Jerry, I just asked you not to do that. Why did you do it?
Well, boys will be boys.
Gee, Mom, you sure work fast. Looks like a wonderful mattress.
Yeah, I got it at Marshall's, and they delivered it right after Viv left for the weekend.
Oh, what'd you do with the old mattress?
Oh, I got a very good deal.
Oh?
They only charged me $2 to haul it away. Well, that's part of the mattress. That's a control.
An electric mattress?
Yeah, vibrates and gives you a massage while you sleep. See, it has two speeds, low and high.
Where's the motor?
Honey, don't move the bed. You make marks on the floor. Honestly, the motor's in the mattress, honey.
Is there anything I can do to help you?
Yeah, would you go down to the hardware store and ask Mr. McClay to give you two hooks for the hall closet?
Oh, all right.
Thank you.
Can I go with it?
Okay, honey.
Whee!
Jerry! Honestly. Oh, boy.
Hi.
Oh, hi, dear. How was the basketball game?
We lost again. That makes the third game in a row.
Well, don't feel too badly. I just lost 9 games in a row myself. Bedtime, Jerry, dear.
Mom?
What?
I sure hate to sleep in my room alone without Sherman.
Now, honey, I'm gonna be right down the hall. Oh, Jerry, why do you leave these stilts in the middle of the floor? Somebody's gonna break their neck.
Hey! Maybe if I can sleep on Aunt Viv's electric mattress, it might make me feel better.
I'm sorry, honey, but I sent that mattress back this afternoon.
Oh. How come?
Well, I tried it out this afternoon, and that bed kind of took off. If Aunt Viv ever went to sleep and left the motor running, she'd wake up halfway to New Rochelle.
But what's she going to sleep on?
Well, I ordered another mattress, an ordinary one that has the decency to just lie there. You'll be out in plenty of time before Aunt Viv gets back.
Good night, Jerry. Good night, Mom.
Good night. Good night, dear. Good night, sweetheart.
Good night, Mom.
Go right to sleep now.
Okay.
Okay. Come on in, honey. I'll turn on the light.
Boy, Mom, I'm sure tired.
Oh, so am I. You want a little snack, a glass of milk, some cookies or
good
something?
Idea.
Oh, honey, I'm so sorry my old car broke down and you didn't even get to see Uncle Ned.
Well, you couldn't help it. It wasn't your fault your transmission dropped out.
That's true. I didn't even know I had one. I'll tell you one thing. The next time we take a trip, I'm going to carry a spare transmission in the glove compartment.
Mom, that wouldn't work. But I'm too tired to explain why.
Well, I'm too tired to understand. Here's your cookies. Come on, bring them upstairs, honey. Oh, I'm so beat. Even that old lumpy mattress of mine's going to feel good tonight. I wish I could say the same for me. How come you changed and got so generous? Well, I just started to feel like a mean old miser. So I bought you a new mattress, and I washed your curtains, and I waxed your floors. How does it look?
Oh, it looks lovely. I never would have thought... Oh, what? Oh,
I'm afraid I got a little carried away with my waxing.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry. Are you all right?
Uh-huh.
Well, it's late. I'll see you in the morning, honey. Sleep well. Nighty-night. You don't have a place to sleep, do you?
No, I don't.
Well, you can sleep in my bed.
Thanks. Wait a minute. Where are you going to sleep?
I meant we could both sleep in my bed.
Oh, no. The last time we did, you ate crackers in bed and hogged all the covers.
Oh.
I woke up feeling like a breaded popsicle.
Well, I suppose I could put Jerry and Sherman in my room and we could sleep in their bunk beds.
Oh, fine. I got two choices. I can freeze with you or twist myself into one of those short little bunk beds, huh?
Well, what'll it be?
Well, I'd rather be a pretzel than a popsicle.
The boys didn't even wake up when I switched them to my bed. And how come you get the lower bunk?
Because I got here first, that's how.
Well, where's the ladder?
Well, the boys haven't used that for ages, don't you remember?
Oh.
They keep it out in their treehouse.
Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. Ow! I'm sorry. You're going to have to help me up here. Bend over. I'll use your back for a step. what for a what? I want to step on your back so I can get up there. Try this. Wait a minute, I'll have to step up here.
All right,
first.
This time.
Wait a minute now. Get over in front of the bunk. Thanks. Space.
Don't tell me where I can have my claustrophobia.
Come on. Change with me, will you?
Oh, good grief. Oh, Viv, honestly. You and your claustrophobia.
Yes.
Apparently, my hands were overloaded.
Watch out for that low
ceiling. Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Than break my neck. Come on, switch with me, will you?
Come on.
Will you?
Come on.
Okay. Turn around.
I think I'll go down and get a snack. You want anything to eat?
Oh, no.
Boy, you must be tired.
Oh,
him? I don't know.
Oh, now that you woke me up, my claustrophobia is back.
Oh, Viv.
Huh? What'll I do?
Look, come on up there with me, and I'll sleep on the outside so you don't fall out. Okay? But I was just trying to do something nice for you.
Oh, that's all right. I understand. It was just bad timing.
Yeah. Well, your new mattress will be here in the morning.
Thank heavens.
Good night, dear.
Good night.
Thank you.